Hello, this is the future.
Hey.
Hello, the future just passed you. She was on her phone, that's why the future passed her. She wasn't paying attention.
Yeah.
Welcome to TRANSLOGIC, I'm Bradley Hazemeyer. In 2011, we had the chance to check out the Audi A3 e-tron. At the time, it was kind of a concept, a test bed, and it was pure electric. Fast forward 2 years, and here we have the variant. It's the A3 e-tron plug-in hybrid. And guess what? You can actually buy this one. All right, so we're here with Oscar from technical development at Audi AG. So today we're in beautiful Santa Monica. We're driving the 2014 Audi A3. This is the e-tron, though. This is the plug-in hybrid. Why was it that Audi decided to kind of get into the plug-in hybrid now?
Plug-in hybrid is the most suitable way to meet the customer expectations.
Okay.
It should support the everyday mobility. Long distance ranges should be easy to do, and it should be easy to charge the car. And most important, it should be cost efficient also,
yeah,
and affordable.
Yeah.
The A3 e-tron combines all these demands.
Yeah, some of the specs on this, about 200 horsepower,
yeah,
roughly 260 pound-feet of torque.
Right.
So it's great, right off the line, of course, like classic electric vehicles.
This is the EV mode, but you can also run it in a hybrid mode, where the combustion engine runs together with the electric motor.
This is the most power you're gonna get,
this is the
right?
most you got power.
Engine giving full force, you got battery giving full force.
Yeah, this is the moment when you have all 260 foot-pound of the system torque. This is the mode where you can gain the top speed of 138 miles per hour.
So you guys are bringing the new A3. This specifically is the e-tron. Tell me a little bit about this car.
We believe in Audi that this is actually the right solution in the next years to avoid that the consumer gets any compromise in terms of performance, in terms of range, or in terms of package.
Was there anything in your development of the technology that is different than just your basic kind of plug-in hybrid?
This car is electric range of 50 kilometers.
Okay.
And you can charge a battery in something more than 2 hours.
So wow, it's fully charged?
Yeah, and this is basically the story. The story is that we try to listen at what the people really need. And they say they don't want, you know, have any compromise in range. They want to go on vacation. Without any problem, they want to charge the battery very quickly, and they still want some exciting performance of the car. So,
and then something that's unique about this is when people buy this car, you're giving them a wall charger included.
We try to facilitate the whole experience of the consumer. We have to try to get those barriers down so that the people don't have, let's say, they don't fear the change.
You have also a so-called hold mode. This ensures that you can store the electrical range, like now 29 miles, to ensure that you can run the last 29 miles on your destination purely electric. It doesn't charge the battery, but
that's
if you want
charge mode.
It's the charge mode.
Yes.
Yeah, you just have to press this button.
Okay.
Charging switched on.
Okay.
And from now on, the combustion engine uses the electric motor to work as a generator to generate power for the high voltage battery that we got here.
And you guys are also introducing the new Mmi interface on this vehicle, and it'll be in subsequent vehicles as well, right?
Yeah, that's right. So the A3 is the first one to have this new technology with a very, very flat screen, a very strong NVIDIA processor.
Yep.
You have a lot of services possible from, you know, Facebook to Twitter, etc. This is the first car with the, you know, the 4G LTE technology.
Yeah, yeah.
So and we know that especially for the young generation, this is a must. Our idea is obviously that we can scale the technology on many, many models. So you're not forced to, I don't know, buy a specific car to benefit of this technology. We will be able to enlarge the offer so that if you want, I don't know, a hatchback, you get it. If you want to, you know,
right.
SUV, you're going to get it. So that's the idea. That's also the advantage.
It's like Mr. Potato Head, the plug-in hybrid Mr. Potato Head.
Yeah, that's right.
What about a plug-in hybrid R8?
Cool, no?
That'd be cool. Oh, so that's not a no. That is not a no. Let's put that on the record.
Yeah, I love it. It's great.
I'll expect delivery in 2015 when it goes on the market.
Great.
I'll wait for it.
So it's still going to be about a year before you can get your hands on one, but it's good to see the e-tron program finally taking off. And we're certainly paying attention to what Audi's got next in line. An R8 e-tron, anyone? All right, for Translogic, I'm Bradley Hasemeyer. See you next time.